Let us go back to Exodus 3, where we hear God calling Moses. Now, a lot happened in Moses' life up to this point, and we're not going to really review all of that. But at one point, Moses is up on the mountain, and there is a burning bush. And in this burning bush, God spoke to Moses. Some of the kids might remember that's one of our stories from Bible school this year. But in the midst of all that, when God was calling Moses, God says, I am. I am. I am who I am. Now, that is a statement that you kind of hear in your mind and you think, wow. But then you almost ask the same question that I'm sure Moses asked. And I'm sure it was asked down through the thousands of years after that. I am what? I am what? Well, we hear God calling Moses, and Moses, after much hesitation, agrees to follow God, and he goes to Egypt, and he brings the Israelites out of Egypt, and they come to the Red Sea, and God miraculously parts the Red Sea. All this wonderful care that God is now showing his people, that he is caring for them, loves them, and wants to deliver them from this bondage, this slavery that they are in Egypt. So they cross the Red Sea. They get into the wilderness, and it's only a few weeks later till suddenly they're moaning and they're groaning and complaining, and saying, we're hungry. It was better when we were back in Egypt. Now we don't have anything to eat, and we're miserable, and they really begin to complain. So what does God do? God sends them manna from heaven. God sends quails for them to eat as meat, but God sends them manna from heaven, this little white flaky substance. And it's there every morning. Now, as the story goes, they're in the wilderness a long time. It didn't have to be that way, but it was. And they're in the wilderness for 40 years. And so they're receiving manna from God, and he takes care of them. That's a lot of manna. You know, we're talking somewhere around 2 million people that went through the wilderness. Somewhere around 2 million. That's a lot of manna. That's a lot of days to eat manna. I imagine they had baked manna and broiled manna and fried manna and manna mixed up in bread and upside down manna cake and maybe even banana manna, whatever they could do. But you can imagine how long that was that these people ate manna. I mean, you can kind of see how that would be. But God, the idea is God provided manna from heaven for them, just to show them that he could take care and would take care of them. Moses took a jar of the manna and preserved it and actually put it in the Ark of the Covenant in front of the Ten Commandments and carried that with them in years to come in the Ark of the Covenant. That's how important it was, the manna from heaven. Now, we really don't know all of that story and what that was all about until we get to the New Testament, of course, and Jesus comes on the scene. And Jesus is born in the humble stable in Bethlehem, and he grows up, and he then ministers to the people, and then we see miracles, and we see Jesus teaching the people. And we come to this wonderful story where Jesus is feeding the 5,000. And what do we hear again? We hear again that God provided food for the people. Another story involving bread from heaven, where it multiplies and comes from God and sustains the people and feeds the people, and they even have bread left over. So again, we see this story of bread from heaven. And what is God trying to tell us? Well, Jesus says, I am the bread of life. We read in our gospel lesson that John, the apostle, begins to give us the understanding of I am what? I am what? Well, John begins to tell us and teach us in the book of John, as Jesus is telling us, I am the bread of life. I am the light of the world. Jesus is giving us the understanding. He is now fulfilling what that bread was all about. That manna from heaven was a type of Christ, so to speak, in that it was showing us God would provide all the people needed in that manna. And the feeding of 5,000, again, is showing us a type of Christ where God would provide and multiply and feed the people. And there would even be abundance left over. And ultimately, God took care of us with the bread of life in his son Jesus Christ. The bread of life actually ends up ultimately being a person in Jesus Christ. Yes, we eat bread to take care of our physical being, don't we? I mean, bread is a pretty awesome food. There's all kinds of wonderful bread. There was all kinds of bread all through the scriptures. Lots of stories about bread. And as we eat bread, it's yummy, and it's filling, and it's nourishing for our physical bodies. It's a great food. But Jesus is saying that he is the spiritual nourishment for our souls. The physical bread will feed us physically, but we're never going to be satisfied. And as they went through the wilderness, what happened? They ate the manna, but ultimately those people died. It was a physical bread from God, but they died. Jesus fed the 5,000. Ultimately, those people died. But the life that Christ can give us, as the bread of life, means that we will never die. He gives us eternal life as the bread of heaven, as the bread of life, as God's bread for us. It is bread that will allow us to live eternally, to have eternal life and to the hope of heaven and all that that brings. The bread of life has personality. The bread of life is a person. The bread of life has power. Power to save, power to satisfy every sinner, and to bring that every sinner to Christ. The bread of life has power to forgive us and to help us to come out of that bondage of sin and to be under the power of God and God in our lives. The bread of life has promise. And that promise is for life. That promise is that we will be able to live and that our souls will be fed and that God will take care of us. And there's that word trust. There's that word faith. We have to walk by faith. We live our Christian life by faith. Faith in God through his son, Jesus Christ. The bread of life, the light of the world, who comes to sustain us. God says, I am what? I am. I am the Alpha and the Omega, the beginning and the end. God says, I am all you need. I am love, I am forgiveness and grace. I will provide your daily needs. I am the Creator. I am the Healer, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. And we could go on and on. And I love that one song we sing, This God, He is Our God. In the middle there, we get to read and worship in the names of God. And every one of those names has meaning, as God is trying to help us to understand that he is all we need. And that he sent his son to be the bread of life. The bread of life to sustain our souls and our spirits. And to help us in all that we do in our daily walk in Christ. Sometimes life has its challenges. Sometimes it has its ups and downs, its surprises. They're not all good. And thank God we can turn to our Savior in Jesus Christ, who will walk with us. Last week, I talked to Tom Bingham. I don't know if you remember Tom Bingham. We prayed for him for a while. He goes to St. James Lutheran Church. He attends there. And 2.5 years ago, he had a brain tumor, and he had it removed in Pittsburgh. And he's been doing so great ever since. They told him that it would come back some days, probably. But of course, many prayers have gone up and have sustained him. And he goes out every month for a CAT scan. Here 2 weeks ago, he did his CAT scan, and they saw a little growth in the tumor. It had begun to grow. So I talked to him last week. He will be home tomorrow. He had to go back out. They were going to remove, again, part of the tumor on Friday. So these kinds of things come upon us, and of course it was a blow to his life. And yet as I talked to him, it was amazing because he just had such peace. He just had faith, he just had trust, And he said, you know what? It's going to be okay. Like, I've just learned to place it in God's hands. He's the great healer. He's the physician. He's the great physician. And I'll be back home Monday. And it's going to be okay. They even have new procedures that are helping him. He was going to actually be awake during that surgery because they were going to go close to his optical nerve. And they wanted him to be awake so that he could tell them what he was seeing, because they didn't want to get too close to his optical nerve that they might cause damage. And if he was awake, he could tell them if he was losing his peripheral vision or whatever. And he said, even in the last 2 years, what a miraculous, a miraculous, the learning more, I'm missing a word I'm trying to say, but the doctors have learned new procedures, and what a miracle in that they could do this procedure for him. I do ask you to pray for him. But in the midst of that story, what I'm trying to say is the bread of life and the bread of heaven is walking with him and sustaining him in even what he was facing in Pittsburgh, and giving him peace, and as he said, his wife had peace, and that they would be okay, and they would be back on Monday. So please pray for Tom Bingham as he goes through this. The bread of life, folks, will sustain our souls and our spirits. Let us have faith and trust in him in our daily walk as we leave this place today. Amen. Now may the peace of God, which passeth all understanding, keep our hearts and our minds through Christ Jesus our Lord. Father, we do come before you, and Lord, we do ask that you would fill us afresh and anew with your Holy Spirit, that your Son, Jesus Christ, would live in us, and that we would have just a growing relationship with you, dear Lord. And Father, we do thank you that you sustained the people in the wilderness with the manna. And Father, we thank you that you fed the 5,000, dear Lord, through your Son, Jesus Christ. What awesome miracles. And dear Lord, we thank you for the person in the bread of life in Jesus Christ. And we thank you that we can share in communion, and we can share in that bread and drink that wine. And Father, we know we are remembering Jesus on the cross. Father, help us today to be encouraged and uplifted. Help us in our good times and in our bad times to come to you and to be sustained by you in our souls, dear Lord. Thank you for your physical abundance as we eat the physical bread and are abundantly cared for. We thank you. And Father, we thank you for caring for our souls and our spirits. We do pray for so many in need. We lift up Tom Bingham as an example of many who are in need of your healing touch, dear Lord. We continue to pray for Janie. Father, we lift up Perk and Janet and all of our older folks in our church family, that you would sustain them and watch over them and give them strength. Father, we ask that you would especially watch over Janet as she goes for her physical therapy, and Sandy Clayton too, that this physical therapy would really work, that it would really help them, dear Lord. And Father, we lift up all those in the hospitals and the nursing homes. And Father, we ask that you would be with those who are grieving the loss of loved ones. We do pray that your healing touch would be on Tom Bingham in his surgery. I'm anxious to talk to him tomorrow, maybe visit with him for a few minutes just to get the update, the story of how everything is going. And Lord, we just know and have faith that you will watch over him and carry him through this, as you have carried him miraculously over these last 2.5 years. We pray for your complete healing for those who are in need. We lift up those who are in surgeries or planning surgeries or in procedures or all those waiting test results and some of the anxieties and fears that come with that. We ask that you would ease our fears and help us, dear Lord, to live in peace, peace of mind and peace of heart. Father, we do pray for our families. We lift up our homes. We ask that you would be with each home. We ask that you would be strong that your presence would be strong in our homes, that you would teach us and guide us, help us to live in harmony and to love each other. We do pray for safe travels for those who have come long distances. We pray for Jason and his whole family. We pray for Clarissa and her family. Lord, as they're with us this morning, and I'm sure quite a blessing to their parents and all of us, we just pray that you would give them safe travels and all those who are traveling. We do pray for our youth and kids that are heading off to camp today. We lift up Dathan and Corey Berkey, and Gracie Strayer and Rachel Weber. Lord, that you would watch over them, that you would protect them, and Lord, that they might learn of you, that they might have just a real wonderful experience at camp this week, at Camp St. Lenota. We just pray for all the staff and all those who are helping to reach these kids, that they would just have a week of growing in their faith, away from TVs and electronics, and just in nature and spending time with you, dear Lord. We pray for them. Father, we pray for this week, that you would help us as we go our separate ways, that you would help us to serve you in all things. We give you honor and glory for this church family and this place, and help us as we go our separate ways, that we might serve you each day. And we pray now the prayer that Jesus taught us to pray. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name, thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen. Father, we do lift up those who have birthdays and anniversaries this week as we celebrate with them. We pray for Betsy Clark, Robbie Bridges, Harrison Coons, Mark Lashley, and Kevin Jones, and ask a special blessing upon them. In Jesus' name, amen. All right, let us continue our service by singing Be Thou My Vision. If you would please rise. What a wonderful hymn. Great words. This is a prayerful melody and hymn. And now for the benediction. The Lord bless you and keep you. The Lord make his face to shine upon you and be gracious unto you. The Lord lift up his countenance upon you and give you peace. In the name of the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit. And all God's people said, Amen. Amen.